in infectious diseases, the fact that you have two living organisms that are sort of battling one another, the host and then the infectious agent, I think it's fascinating. I saw infectious disease as a place where I could have an impact to improve the lives of people around the world. When the COVID-19 pandemic struck, my lab got really invested in identifying possible drugs that might kill the virus and in testing new methods and new devices to decontaminate PPE for healthcare workers. Right now, our primary focus is on taking drugs that already have FDA approval and seeing if they have any impact on preventing virus from growing in cells. One of the things that makes us especially unique is that the Center for Emerging and Neglected Diseases just established a drug screening facility. So we have the ability to screen thousands and even millions of drugs that might kill the virus. Early in the pandemic, I was contacted by some friends of mine who are healthcare practitioners in the East Bay, who told me that they had no PPE for use with patients. In a perfect world, the supply chains would be there, but since that's not happening, the next best thing we can do is try to help them prolong the life of the PPE that they have so that they can be protected when they see patients. One of the things that has been really inspiring and motivating for me during this time has been that everyone who has any kind of expertise on campus is thinking really hard about how to interrupt and stop the COVID-19 pandemic. We have a Biosafety Level 3 laboratory, which is engineered to protect the workers from pathogens that are spread through the air. Most universities don't have access to a BSL3 facility. We've opened up the lab to investigators across campus who are submitting their ideas, and we actually carry out these experiments using the live virus in collaboration with them. Right now, I'm primarily funding this research myself with my discretionary research funds, but of course, this work is very expensive, and so I and my collaborators have been applying through various funding mechanisms to try to acquire funding. Coronaviruses have hopped into the human population before COVID-19, and they likely will again. And so that the more we can understand about these viruses, the more prepared we'll be for the next potential pandemic. I'm Sarah Stanley, and I'm lighting the way to finding new drugs for COVID-19.